I know why you're here. You want to take your own x-rays at home, don't you? Well, you really can't, but what you can do is learn how to make this dope x-ray effect inside of Davinci Resolve. You're not gonna wanna miss this one. And you wanna know what else you don't wanna miss? Our brand new website full of our easy to use Davinci Resolve titles, transitions, and effects that will help you create higher quality videos faster. So check us out in the link below. So first things first, you gotta get some footage. Now I literally put a green background on my phone and then I just recorded myself putting my hand up and then I waved my phone in front of my hand. Now I made sure to not cover my fingertips and I'm gonna show you exactly why this was important later on in the video. If you wanna follow along, you can download everything for this project for free in the description below. I mean, why not? It's free footage. So now that we have our footage in DaVinci Resolve, we need to remove this green screen on my phone. So we're gonna open up the effects menu here and then go down to open effects. Then grab the 3D keyer and add it to our clip. In the inspector tab, I'm gonna click effects so we can actually see our 3D keyer settings. Then I'm gonna click this turkey baster looking thing. It's called the picker, but I like turkey baster. Anyway, we're gonna turn on the open effects overlay in this drop-down menu right over here. This is gonna allow us to select and remove colors from our footage. Now everything in the dark area is being removed. If you didn't remove all the green, you can just add to the selection by clicking this add button right here and draw over the green until it's completely gone. Now in the inspector tab, scroll down to despill and crank that bad girl up to remove any green spill from the image. Then go down to matte finesse and bring up the clean black a bit so we can just clean up the edges. Of course, this is just one of the ways you can remove green screen. I have a video about all the other ways you can do that as well, so I'll just link that in the card above. So once our green screen's removed, I'm gonna right click on this clip and select new fusion clip. Do you know what that means? We're going into fusion! So to make this effect in Fusion, we need to track my hand so that we can actually stick the x-ray to it. I'm gonna pull up the Select Tools menu by hitting Control and Spacebar and then type in Tracker. Then just add it into the node Flow. I think that's what it's called. I don't really know. Now, when I recorded my footage, I didn't cover my fingertips. And that's because we need something to actually track our x-ray to. So I'll place a few tracking points on my fingertips and make sure that the tracking area isn't too big because otherwise it's gonna catch on to other things and it'll wander off. So keep it to, you know, the area you wanna actually track. Once you put the trackers out, go to adaptive mode and change it to best match. Then bring down the match tolerance to like 0.300. That'll work fine. Now I'll hit track forward from current time because the beginning of my clip won't track well because I was moving a lot. Once our clip is tracked, I'm gonna grab the x-ray and merge it in with the tracker. To do that, I'm gonna drag the x-ray output to the tracker output so that they actually merge together. Next, I'll grab a background node and merge it together with the media in too, which is our x-ray. We can see though that there's a bit of an issue. The x-ray just isn't there anymore. That's mainly because our merge node is sending the x-ray to the background and the background node to the foreground. So we gotta switch that up by hitting Control T on the keyboard. You can see that the inputs will actually switch. So once you've done that, click on merge one and under apply mode, select screen. And essentially what screen is gonna do is remove all of the black from the shot so that it's just the white showing up. Now I need to line up the x-ray to my hand, so I'll grab a transform node and add it in after my merge to node. Then uncheck use size and aspects so that we can move our x and y sizes freely from one another. So now I'll line it up as close as I can with the transform node, but the reality is we're not gonna be able to get it perfect. And that's all right because I got some tricks up my sleeve. Like right there. Like it's there. So pull up the Select Tools menu again, and this time type in Grid Warp, then add it in after our Transform 1 node. Essentially, this is gonna allow us to warp our image, in this case, our x-ray. So in the Inspector tab, increase our grid size to 50, and now we have a ton of grid points everywhere. Under Magnet Type, I'm gonna click on Select It. This is gonna allow me to select a group of grid points and move it in any way I want. I'm gonna start adjusting this x-ray so that it lines up with my hand. Once we've done that, I need to add in one more transform node after my grid warp. Now, this node is gonna host all of our tracking data. I'm gonna have more in-depth and beginner videos on things that you can do with tracking coming soon. So get subscribed and hit the bell so you don't miss out on any of that. So I'm gonna right click under center X and Y, then go to connect to tracker one, then on steady position. And unfortunately, when we do this, it moves just a little bit, but don't worry. Use your transform one to move it back into place. Once you've done that, we can go to our merge one node right here and change our apply mode back to normal. And to have our phone reveal the X-ray, I need to actually send it to the background. So like we did earlier, switch the inputs by hitting Control T on our keyboard. So now it just disappears altogether. And you can see though that there is a checkered background. And that's because essentially we have a hole in our image because we removed that green screen earlier. But don't worry about it, seriously, because it's gonna default to black and our X-ray has a black background as well. Now, all that's left to do is run through the video and actually make sure that our X-ray lines up with our fingers. And if it doesn't, use the grid warp to adjust it, because remember, we animated it earlier, so you can keep adding animation points on it. So once you do that, we are good to go. Now we are trying to hit 200,000 subscribers on this channel by the end of 2022. So if you haven't yet, subscribe to this channel so we can crush that goal and keep on moving. And if you haven't yet seen our newest masking effects video, check that one out because there are three super creative masking effects that you could learn for your videos. Anyway, until the next one, peace.